Hey everyone, Rodney here, just with another wee basic tutorial. So today we're going to cover Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses. Now this is not the Slash all singing, all dancing. We'll get Scott to do that again. This is just something that you can learn a popular song which everyone loves to sing with four chords and a nice easy strum pattern. So we're going to cover Sweet Child of Mine just now.
Got a smile, and it seems to me reminds me of childhood memories. Whenever a thing was as fresh as the bright blue sky. Now and then, when I see her face, she takes me away to that special place, and if I stay too long, I'd probably break down and cry. Oh, 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 sweet child of mine. Oh, 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 sweet love of mine.
Okay guys, so I'm going to take you through the chords. Just to say, I'm playing this today on our Faith Blue Moon, which is the brother or sister of the very famous Blood Moon, which we can never ever keep in stock because they're so popular. Such a great sounding guitar, both acoustically and plugged in. This is a great present for anyone who's looking to get a more professional guitar. We'll do a cracking deal on it, so get in touch if you're interested, you like the sound of it. But for now, we're going to go through the chords of the song. So, Sweet Child of Mine. We're doing it in D, which is what the original is in, maybe drop down or something like that, but we're going to do it in D today. So we've got four chords. We've got our D, which is 2nd fret, 4th string down with the 1st finger. Our 2nd finger's going on the bottom string in the 2nd fret, and then our 3rd finger is going on the 5th string down in the 3rd fret, okay? And that's our D. Now we're strumming pretty much from the 2nd or 3rd string down. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so we're strumming from the 2nd, so we're going with our D. Now, some of you may have noticed that I play in the C like this, okay? You can also play a C like that. I tend to play it like that. It gives it a bit more of a fuller sound. Whenever I'm gigging and stuff, you're just trying, you've got nothing else with you. You're singing on your own, so it's just a nice full sound. So I've got my 1st finger on the 5th string down in the 1st fret. Then I've got my 2nd finger on the 3rd string down in the 2nd fret. Then I've got my 3rd finger on the top string, the 3rd fret. And then I've got my wee finger, pinky finger, on the 2nd string down in the 3rd fret. So it sounds like this. And then we've got a G, okay, which again can be played three ways, maybe even more, but the popular ways is like this, or like this. I play it like that. Doesn't matter which way you play it, it still works for the song. So we've got 2nd string down, 2nd fret, 1st finger. Then we've got a 2nd finger on the top string and 3rd fret, all the way down, 5th string down in the 3rd fret, and then our wee finger going on the bottom string, also in the 3rd fret. Okay, we've also got an A when we go on to the chorus. Okay, now I'm just going, there's a couple of ways that we can play an A. Okay, and we can play it with 2 fingers. If you're really only starting out, 2 fingers might be easy. The proper way to play it is with 3 fingers like this, but if you've got fat fingers like me, I play it with 1 finger like this, or sometimes these here. Okay, ultimately you're covering the 3rd string, it's all inside the 2nd fret. You're covering the 3rd string, the 4th string and the 5th string inside the 2nd fret, and you're strumming from the 2nd string down. I play it like that. So that's our D, our C, our G, and we get to the chorus, we've got an A, 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 whichever way you want to do it. Now, for our strum, D This song can be played with a basic strum. Like what we did with our last video, which Stamp 8 can be played with 1, 2, 3, and 4, and, okay? But I've structured this one just so that if you've been playing a while, you're comfortable moving between chords, we could give you a little bit more of a difficult strum. So again, just like the last video we done, it's in 4-4 time. So it's based around 1, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna add in some extra notes just to give it a fuller sound. And it's gonna sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, I'm gonna slow that down. 1, 2, 3, 4. So what I recommend you do, get that count right, okay? Then just make sure you get the note value right. So follow along with what I'm doing. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get that count right, okay? Then get the note value right and then start to just get your hand to follow along with your count or follow along to the video on what I'm doing. So on a D chord, that sounds like this. And so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play the chords without singing. Some of you might be glad to hear. Play the chords without singing just so that you can see how that works. I'm gonna do a turn through the verse and then a turn through the chorus. Here we go. Thanks for listening, everyone, for tuning in and watching. Remember to stick your email, press the button below, stick your email in. We'll send you across the PDF, the YouTube link to the song, so you can break it down, pause it, and go through and learn it for yourself. I hope you really enjoyed that. We'll be coming to you with a few more of those and a few more videos. So please stay in touch, keep tuning in, and we'll see you soon.